first got out here, you know, I reached out to a few YouTubers and say, hey, you know, which performance indicators do you guys monitor regularly? And I never got an answer back from anybody, or a straight answer. So after, you know, trial and error, this is my setup. I ended up, a lot of you guys actually will have the smaller instrument cluster. As you can see, I got the large 7-inch now. I'll actually put a link down in the description to a website to a buddy of mine. Where you can order the large instrument cluster, and he can program it with all your current miles on there, your hours, and all of that as well, so you don't lose any of that information. But anyhow, the performance indicators that I drive by is basically I go by boost and EGT, and this right here is a performance monitor that plugs in the ODDP port and reads the information off of your ECU. I'm going to eventually replace those with two manual indicators. The round ones, the fourth gen matching gauges by an altimeter, I think. Just a single boost and a single EGT. Anyhow, I drive by boost, EGT, my RPM, and right there, coolant temp. And also I monitor trends and oil temp and oil pressure right there. But doesn't really, I try to keep my boost low and my EGTs at 1,000 or under. RPM's around, right now they're what, I don't know, 1600. But temperature's 208. Actually, well, I'm doing this two-handed. Can't really, you hear a downshift in there. But normally I try to keep the RPM right around 2 grand if I'm pulling a yield. And that'll keep my boost down, under 12, and my EGT's around 1,000 or lower, and my temperature's down around 200. And that's, even if I'm doing 20 miles an hour in second gear up a hill with a load, I keep those EGT's and boost down, which keeps your temperatures down. But I only get such performance when the RPM is right there at 1950, basically. That's the sweet spot for me. It may be different for your truck. But anyhow, this is the gauge setup I use, the gauge and the performance indicators that I monitor. You know? Yeah, like I said, I'll put a link down in the description to my friend's website. He can hook you up with a large 7-inch cluster right there and program it to your current mileage and run time, idle time, and all that stuff for you as well. So, anyhow, I hope that helps some of you guys out there. In case you are wondering which indicators to monitor. But yeah, all right, be safe out there on the road. Alright, okay. Alright, here we go. See, I manually put her in fifth gear. Doing 55. Cruise is set. EGTs are down 800, 900, but that temperature 195. Pulling a hill. RPM was staying right around 2 grand. fifth gear, manually set. But yeah, I can boost her up close to 60 miles an hour, keep her in fifth, and keep that RPM right there at right around 2 grand, and keep everything in check. Some of you guys are like, why? I do 75, I do speed limit. And how many times you rebuilt your motor, your turbo, injectors? Yeah. Me, I do at most 65. So I got a little lightweight, but I'm hauling about 20,000 pounds right now. If I'm hauling something light, yeah, I'll do 65. But when I'm hauling 20,000 pounds, go a little bit slower so I don't stress the motor. Alright, see you guys out there. Be safe. Alright, some of you guys are going to ask me, how about my check engine light? Let's check my engine light while I'm sitting here. Fan control high. That's because about a year ago I switched to a Ford mechanical OBS fan clutch, and that's why that's still there. And yes, there goes my hanging shirts right there, my uniform shirts I wear. I was talking about high vis. And yes, I make my bunk because I'm old school. But yeah, all right, I've been here, sitting here long enough. But yeah, my check engine light right there, that's because of the fan clutch. And I did a video on it almost a year ago, I do believe. But yeah, and actually, yeah, the Ford OBS fan clutch has been running fine. Can't really tell a difference in running temperatures between that and the electronic one. But yeah, I had the serpentine belt went out, and when it went out, it took the connector in for the electronic fan clutch. So I just got on that website down there. Those guys in Arizona, I think, Phoenix, and they machined all the necessary stuff to convert to a Ford OBS fan clutch. And that's what I did, and I think I'm using an old 5.9 fan, or maybe it's a Ford OBS fan as well. But yeah, anyhow, nope. You guys wonder about my check engine light? That's why. Fan clutch. Alright, see you guys later. Be safe out there.